Welcome to the Mortal Billiards Championship Tournament match between Jump Shot Jeremy and 8 Ball English for the MBC Trophy. I am Freestyle Phillips, and I have a very special guest with me, match participant, small ball, I mean 8 Ball English.
Thank you, Freestyle Phillips. So here we are, it's me versus Jeremy.
And he's lining up. Wow, he's taking a long time to think about this.
Good thing it's not a quickfire match, eh?
He definitely thinks hard, and then shoots soft.
Isn't that usually his way? He's a little soft every time.
Ooh, you'd have to ask
Cam Jamaloy on that one.
You got it. And he failed that one pretty badly.
And here I come, like, look at how good looking I am. I perfectly line it up, just tap.
And so,
I'm
so
just working
poor.
With what I want to do. Don't worry, I've got it all lined up. I'm very methodical when I play. I want to make sure that no matter what.
Oh, look at that handsome face.
Look at that.
And there's one only a mother could love.
Yes, I know. Her mother and her daughter all love me. Sometimes the grandmother too, but you know.
Aww.
Who am I to judge? Look, taking forever on his shot again.
Yep.
And he still fucks it up.
But at least we've got some nice camera shots in the background.
Absolutely. And the foreground, just look at how beautiful this is.
That was a beautiful shot, I do have to admit.
I was talking about the shooter, not the shot, but you know.
I work with what I'm given. And there's the proof. Alrighty, so back into this match with another long wait for Jeremy.
I wonder if he's like taking his time because he knows how long it takes to get across the bridge in the morning and in the afternoon. Like, he's doing the same amount of time. Do, 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 do. There we go. And he misses that shot.
And he misses the rebound as well. Alrighty. So this match.
No,
is...
I think he actually got one in the corner, though, which makes a change.
Oh. Oh. Missed that one just by an inch. But inch, mile, doesn't matter here. Still a miss.
Is this why you keep saying everything's like 6 miles, but it's only 6 inches?
Ooh, that was actually a really beautiful shot there.
Of course.
Lined yourself up nicely for the next few, too, looks like. And here goes English's next shot. Oh. Oh.
But I've cornered that pocket the way I want it to.
That is a beautiful blocker right there. Now, how many shots does he actually have going for him? Very few, it appears.
I've just realized, if you notice how Jump Shot Jeremy's not wearing his usual attire tonight.
Yeah, I wonder what happened to that other shirt that he always wears.
I think he's getting it custom an addition put onto it where it says eat, sleep, compete, but it doesn't actually say win.
Oh, really?
So.
Hmm.
Whereas you notice I'm sporting my usual attire of my blood-soaked shirt to match Hannah, my beautiful cue.
Oh, and she is a beaut, that is for sure. And you smack her on the table.
You know, I like to give her a little bit of a slap here and there. You know, just keep her on her toes.
And
it's
that
okay,
is
she
a
likes
beautiful,
it.
Beautiful roll.
Absolutely.
A little bit more power and you would have had one in at least.
And Jeremy's thinking... You need to remember, he's got slow wheels up there.
Yeah.
They move a little slow.
Even when he tries to move fast, he moves slow.
Including the cue ball into the side pocket there.
Yeah, that was... I don't think that was what he had initially planned to try and do.
You really think he planned anything?
I could see the smoke coming out of his ears. Ooh. That was a close one.
That was. You know what? I hold my hands up on that one. That was a difficult shot, but I figured I'd try.
And the smoke is arriving again. You know what they say. The wheel is spinning, but the hamster is dead. And the shot. And
the sink.
The sink. Oh, boy.
Jeremy's sending up so many smoke signals every time. Like, even the natives down the road are starting to wonder what's going on.
Ooh. Oh. Oh, that was... Could have been a bit better lined up there.
That one I really didn't have a whole lot of shot for, but, you know, I figured I'd take something.
In the end, as long as you're trying something and not sinking the white ball like Dessa does, you're pretty much good to go.
Absolutely.
Ooh.
I'm seriously wondering, though, like, when they were handing out brains, I honestly think Jeremy thought they said trains, so he asked for a really slow one. It seems like he takes forever for a shot, and there's a cue ball in the pocket again.
Again. Goodness gracious, Jeremy really has to start looking at where his balls are going to fall, says the guy who enjoys putting his white ball in the side pocket.
You know, I honestly think Jeremy's still waiting for his balls to fall.
Ha! Oh, that was a beautiful shot, all the way down.
You can definitely tell, though, when I'm playing, the difference between when I'm playing for fun and when I'm starting to get serious, because the tone of my face changes.
Oh, definitely. It goes from a nice smirk on it to just flat, calculated, cold eyes.
I have been accused of playing pool like a game of chess, but I honestly believe that when playing for a serious game, it is a game of chess.
Oh, definitely. You have to plan out what you're going to be doing, while at the same time thinking 2, 3, or 4 shots ahead as to what your opponent is going to do. Because otherwise, they're going to leave you in the dust.
Kind of like that one was.
That was beautiful. Wish we had seen it. And... Oh! Dirty pool. Dirty. Dirty pool. You left him with one shot.
Absolutely.
And...
Can he pull it off?
Smoke signals. There we go.
I figured slow trains.
Oh, he sank a ball.
Thank you very much, Jeremy.
Wasn't his ball, but he sank a ball.
At this point, it makes it a 4-1 game right now.
Yeah, you are taking him to the cleaners. And he misses his shot, and it appears he's maybe lined you up?
No, I think that's a little too harsh. There you go.
Okay, yeah. Little bit less of an angle, and you could have had a possibility, but I think the other ball was in the way for that shot. But he's now made it... Or actually, you've made it a little bit difficult on yourself, putting that 8-ball in front of yours.
I don't think so, though, because you need to remember, I'm also good at those banked angled shots.
You do enjoy doing the around the world. Oh, and he left you wide open for that shot. He left you completely alone. And the shot is... Not quite, but now you've left yourself in a very good position.
Absolutely. I don't make any shot unless it is worth it.
Can he do it? Anything here?
Other than stand around thinking.
Does not even get the defensive off. If he had been able to put a little less power and sat his ball in front of yours, this would not have happened. There it goes. And you've got a beautiful little line there going towards the side pocket.
That was a nice little snipe from one end of the table to the other.
And the shot.
Lines it up and sinks
it. Beautiful.
Did you really expect anything less?
And welcome back to the Mortal Billiards Championship Quickfire Match. Breaking, we have Jump Shot Jeremy, who doesn't sink a single thing. So it is up to my man, 8-Ball Small Ball English, to take it up.
And yet I still managed to sink something, so I gotta come around and take my second shot.
Yes, but that second shot really didn't do a heck of a lot, so it's up to Matrix Brown to start taking things out. He does right off the bat.
Absolutely. Lines up the second and sinks that one. That is such a beautiful lineup for the second. Comes in for the third on the countdown and just misses.
Oh, that would have been very nice if he had made it. Now, who's this handsome devil?
I'm going to hazard a guess and say somebody that doesn't do anything with balls other than sink his own cue ball.
Oh, and I am gone. And now it's time for Jenna Jaguar.
Let's see.
Sometime.
She's taking almost as long as Jeremy.
Ooh. There we go. And nothing that time.
Speaking of Jeremy, here he comes.
Ooh. And there he goes. Oh, no, or not. Oh, that was a beautiful little shot, followed by a not so beautiful little shot.
I gotta say, though, that was a beautiful chaser.
It was. Oh, just a rattler in the corner. And Sean Brown lines up
and sends it side to side.
Then we've got Jenna once more.
I gotta say, I always love watching Jenna take her shots.
She's gotten a lot better over the past while. Initially, she was playing and she had no form at all, but she has been learning a lot from multiple players on the team.
And I come in and I sink.
That was a fairly easy shot, though, for most people except me. Oh, and out goes another.
No, I or just not. Missed that one.
Oh, it
Matrix
looked like
Brown
it was.
Got that one.
And
oh, a little pop fly.
And oh, it's safe. Jenna lines up.
You know, going back to Jenna, I gotta say, watching her play from when she first came and having a difficult time lining up some good shots.
Mm-hmm.
To coming into actually being able to hold her own in a game now.
Oh, definitely.
You know, she's definitely got contendership for this next year's, you know, Most Improved Player award.
Most definitely. She's been bringing up her game every single time. Oh, and wow, that opened up the table nicely thanks to Matrix Brown. That one, not so much. Alrighty. And nothing off that one, unfortunately. And 8-Ball English does not make a shot on that one, unfortunately.
One thing I've learned with this game, though, it isn't about how many balls you sink. It's about what balls you sink.
I'd say it's how long you last. Oh, and Sean Matrix brings one down. Oh, and that was very close to a suicide.
Speaking of how long it lasts, apparently you don't last too long, eh?
Oh, now you're playing with fire.
I mean, even Jeremy's lasting longer than you.
And he sinks a very nice shot there. Oh, so close to knocking himself out there. And oh, takes another one. He's on a little bit of a roll now. And a nice little lineup.
Nice little bounce off that.
Definitely. Oh, and he misses the shot. And it's 8-Ball English's turn now. Does not sink a thing On to Matrix Brown. Oh, that was a nice little shot there. Just a few little bounces. Oh, had she not been knocking over the white ball there, that actually had a chance of making it in there, I think. Oh, wait, English.
Nope.
Oh, that was close.
That was. Let's see. And I sink that one in.
There goes. Next shot. A little bit of white flash. Oh!
You know, I've got to give way for the younger generation to come in and take the championship belts once in a while.
I mean, you can keep telling yourself that, but at the end of the night, you still dropped the white ball.
You know what? I still walked away with a trophy at the end of the night, so you know what? I dropped this one to give somebody else a chance at gold. That is my excuse, and I'm sticking to it.
Oh, boy. That is close one. So at this point, we've got Matrix Brown, we've got Jenna Jaguar, and we have, Jump Shot Jeremy left. And Jenna takes her shot. Oh, very nice little bounce off that. There was a good chance that could have bounced off into the eight ball, but she managed to save it.
I gotta say, you know, you only ever seem to use the word bounce a lot when Jenna is taking her shot.
You had to mention that.
I'm only pointing out the observation here. I mean, people at home can make their own decisions on this. And that was a nice little close shot.
Definitely. Oh, it's lined up.
Matrix Brown.
Oh. Is that?
Matrix Brown gets eliminated.
Kills himself. So close to the end, too.
Oh, this is a tight game.
Oh, but it's also very close because most of those shots like going back to the corner where that eight ball is just hiding. Oh, and that would have been beautiful. And the shot.
Jeremy lines it up.
Oh, missed the lineup. Oh, missed it for a second time.
And that wasn't much off. That was just a hair
very
off.
Close. Oh, this looks like he's trying to set her up for defeat.
Yep, that's what's happening. And Jenna's not having any of it. She's playing his own game back at her.
Can he do it? Oh, not even trying, just trying to stay alive at this point. Playing a player, not playing the game.
Absolutely.
Oh, that was so close.
And Jeremy's waiting.
That was very close.
That was on the wire.
I think we might have to review that one later.
You know, I think I'm getting word from NBC management that one is under fire to see if he was, in fact, within time.
Alrighty, well, we'll get back at the end of this match to let you know the results. In the end, though... Oh, no. Oh, no.
No.
Oh.
And welcome back to the Motor Billiards Championship Tournament Final. This one is for the NBC Championship belt. We have Unbreakable Baton breaking up against Asher.
And that is a very nice wide break. He ended up clearing up a lot of the stuck balls. However, he didn't actually sink anything. So it's up to Asher to take something out off the table. She's looking around, seeing what's just there. Oh, looks like she's made a decision. Let's see how she does. Ooh, she knocked off the eight ball there.
Nice little spin on the 10 ball there, though.
Mm-hmm. It went nicely where I think she may have wanted it to go, other than in the pocket.
Well, Nick kind of just pushes them around a little bit.
I think he's taking a page from Jenna Jaguar's book, letting the player play themselves. However, she Ash sank is, something.
Nice. Ash has been a very surprising player to watch over the past few tournaments. And I mean, she's gone where she can, you know, send a ball in a direction that I don't think anybody else, including professionals, could do. Mm-hmm. To being able to pull out some beautiful shots.
Yeah, she's been steadily increasing the quality of her play. Meanwhile, Nick has been steadily decreasing the quality of his play.
Which should leave me open for next tournament to, you know, leave him crying in the corner like a little girl.
That is if he wins.
And if he loses, he may have to change out his tampon.
Oh, and he misses the shot. That was a beautiful straight line, and he didn't follow it. Oh, and she just sank something, but was that one of hers?
I don't believe so. I think that was one of Nick's.
Ooh, is she giving him a little bit of a helping hand since he can't seem to do it himself?
Quite possibly.
Because he definitely didn't do that one.
I don't know, I'm starting to see that little smirk on Ash's face there, as if to say, like, do I actually have this game?
Well, we'll just have to wait and see. And she lines up for her next shot, and didn't do much of anything on that one, unfortunately.
Though she did block Nick's four ball right there. Which means she can't come on from the side on that. It's leaving it more and more closed in.
I'm wondering if Nick is actually trying to have Asha play herself. See if she will sink the white ball so he doesn't actually have to do anything. Or if he's just having a bad game. Lines up and... Oh, I'm thinking that might be the bad game coming on.
I think so too. I'm actually starting to wonder if Nick is actually growing taller, which means the tables seem to be getting smaller for him, which means he's having a harder time shooting, because he's really having to bend low for these tables tonight.
Yeah, whereas Asha, it's almost a perfect straight shot for her, so she's got a much better view of where things are going to be going. That was a very nice shot, though. Didn't get anything in the pocket, but it's definitely lining things up, putting blockers in the way.
That being said, though, I mean, I'm not sure if it's him growing or if he's just borrowed Jumpshot Jeremy's step stool.
Oh, that is a story we will definitely have to share at a later time. But that shot that he just made, it's not that great. Oh, speaking neither of was that one, though. Oh, that is a very bad shot there. And... Oh, he clears it up a bit, and so close. So close to getting something in.
Though he has blocked that pocket from three of those balls going in that are very close to it.
That is true. So that was actually a very good shot, if that was actually what he planned to do. Ooh, didn't do much there, unfortunately.
It seems like Ash is having a hard time hitting the solid balls, which is what she is right now.
I think she may have mixed up which one she's supposed to be shooting for.
Nick, on the other hand, seems to have mixed up what the pocket is and what it isn't. Even Ash just looked down going, "What was that?"
Everything that she's got is blocked by something. Let's see what she tries here.
Does it sneak?
Wait. That is a beautiful little blocker there. He has very little angle to shoot.
Forcing him to play something and left it in there.
Was that a scratch? Did he hit the yellow ball first?
I think he did. However, Ash is choosing to play from where it is.
And... No.
Choosing to scratch from where it was, too.
Oh, wow. This game is really back and forth. Now, Nick's left himself with very few shots due to the fact that everything is bunched up in that corner. And he's putting more in that area. Oh, no, it's coming back out. Never mind.
But that being said, Asher still has that 4 blocking the 13.
Oh, she scratches again, but she gets that ball out a little bit, which for the angled shots is a little bit nicer. If it's right against the bumper, then especially for less experienced players, those shots having to have it roll down the bumper is a lot more difficult.
No, absolutely. And I was mistaken, that's the 11 ball, not the 13.
Yes.
It's the old age, it's not keeping up with me these days. I think I need another beer.
Just gonna keep my mouth shut on the old age comment, because... yeah, we'll leave it at that. Alrighty, so she takes a shot, but doesn't get anything in, so it's back to Nick. Nice hit. Didn't really do much of anything. Oh,
no.
Oh,
he did.
It went in. Beautiful. Nice.
I think he may have cleaned his glasses so he can see what he's doing.
Oh, and there goes another one. He is starting to get his groove back, I think. See what he can do. And another.
Though it did just kind of leave him a little foobard right there for that corner. Let's see what he can do on this. Ooh. Oh.
Alrighty.
My suggestion for this one would be to actually just send that cue ball into the corner just to try and push some of her balls to block him on that other corner. That would be my suggestion for Asher. But she goes for the 4.
Which and happens to go in. Even Nick was not expecting that. He was as shocked as the rest of us.
I think Asher was more shocked than anybody.
So now she knows that she has to send everything down this way. But there is that one blocker in the corner. She's either got to sneak it past or just... snuck it past beautifully. And a second.
And a double at that.
Wow.
I don't know if you noticed, but did you not notice how she just blocked his ball as well?
I did not. We'll have to review that.
Here right there. Oh. The 4's blocking.
Wow.
Not only was she able to sneak it past, but also send a 4 in for a block.
Wow. Now, her game has definitely gone up.
Oh.
And then she removed her own blocker, but Nick's not taking advantage of that. But he does still sink something, yes. Which is the important part for at this point in the game. At this point, he just wants to get his balls off the table.
Yeah, but he's still stroking his shaft way too much.
Ooh.
That lines up Asher beautifully to take on that 5.
Let's see if she can actually take advantage. And... oh, sinks one of Nick's balls. So Nick now only has 1 ball, then the 8, and she's still got 3. But seeing as how Nick's playing, that might actually not be a detriment to her. And so she lines up for her next shot.
Taking on the 4.
Oh my goodness. That was a beautiful shot.
And this is why she won the trophy last month.
She gets those shots that nobody thinks that you're going to go for, and she just gets them.
She plays the, I don't know what I'm doing, I don't know how to take these shots, and she plays those really well.
Oh goodness. But look at this angle he's got.
Oh. I'm a firm believer that Asher is a force to be reckoned with.
Oh! Close. Oh, wow. That was nearly suicide for Nick Batten. What does she do with this now?
Leaving Asher for an end-to-end here.
Ooh, so close. Now, she just gave Nick what he gave her, but he's got a little bit better shot. Oh, he still does not get it. Oh, goodness.
This is such a close game. This is anybody's right now. We're 2-1. Speaking of the 2.
No, it's getting close.
Oh, the three is getting lined up there.
And he tries his second attempt and drops that one as well. This could be a very nice shot if she can get this in. It's fairly straight. And the shot. Oh, no. Oh, she still hit though. So she's not quite what she was wanting, but she still does not scratch, which is good for her.
Nick sends it off to the side. Now that was one of the shots I was talking about with Asher, where she comes out with these weird angles that even professionals are still looking at going, what the hell?
Yeah. Now she's wondering, what the hell? How is she going to make anything from that? So, decides to avoid it. That's the one perk of having extra balls on the table.
Yep.
You get to choose. Oh, goodness. And now she's starting to block that corner. Oh, nope. Did not. Had that stop just a few inches closer, she could have a very nice blocker. But
it's still close enough where it's...
Oh! Nick did what she wanted to. And it's perfectly in the center of that pocket. Now, she has no idea what she's going to do at this point. That's a very tight squeeze to make that through.
That'd be something that I would pull off just for fun. Is to come out and take on that shot.
Oh, no.
And she scratches, which means Nick gets to either play from where it is or play from the kitchen. And he's going to choose from where it is because it's lined up perfectly for him. He sinks it.
Beautiful shot at that.
And it looks like he may have just lined himself up to win the game.
Ooh, very nice.
The only way is if he screws this up royally or if the cue ball goes in with the 8. It's lining up for a straight on shot.
Sinks the 8 ball.
Way to go, Nick.